Welcome back. In the last video, we saw how you could accelerate simulations through fast restart. In this video, we'll talk about another method of accelerating your simulations when you are dealing with a lot of simulations, such as when you do a parameter sweep or Monte Carlo simulations. You can do this by running those multiple simulations in parallel. Before we talk about the details, let's have a quick overview of what parallel computing in MATLAB means in general. So parallel computing is available through the Parallel Computing Toolbox and MATLAB Parallel Server and is based on MATLAB Workers or MATLAB Computational Engines. You can also think of them as headless MATLAB sessions. And these MATLAB sessions or workers can be associated with multiple cores on your desktop machine. They can also be associated on clusters and clouds. A collection of these workers are referred to as a parallel pool, and simulations can be assigned to these MATLAB workers by using the parsim command to facilitate parallel simulations. Parsim is a convenient and efficient way to run lots of simulations in parallel, either using the local MATLAB pool on your desktop or a MATLAB pool in a cluster. Parsim works in conjunction with the simulation input object, which helps you set up all your simulation inputs in a convenient way, including variables, block parameters, and simulation configurations. The parsim command can take an array of simulation input objects and run those simulations in parallel, if MATLAB parallel computing tools are available. Otherwise, the simulations are run serially. Let's demonstrate the power of running parallel simulations using parsim. For this, let's use a model of a hybrid electric vehicle. So this model consists of thousands of blocks and takes a while to update and simulate. I ran this model before, and for one run, it takes around 2.5 minutes. Now, if you wanted to run, say, 100 simulations for a parameter sweep one after the other, it would take close to 4 hours. Now, I have this script that will help us set this model up for parallel simulations to carry out parameter sweeps for different masses and differential torque ratios for the car and determine the overall fuel usage. Section 1 in this live script just sets up the Simulink project for this model. Section 2 here creates 100 parameter sets for the mass and differential torque parameters. Section 3 creates 100 simulation input objects for these 100 simulations that we will run using the parsim command. Each of these simulation input objects contains the parameter set for that simulation. In section 4, there are commands that run the parallel simulations, and section 5 has code to plot the fuel usage for each of the parameter sets. Now that this is set up, let's run these simulations in parallel. First, let's see how we can run parallel simulations on our local machines. The parpool command with the local argument finds different cores in the local machine and creates a parallel pool of MATLAB workers. Once we run the parsim command, MATLAB created and connected to 4 local workers in my case. Then it sets up Simulink and assigns simulations to each worker, after which the simulations are run. We see that the simulations have run successfully and the fuel usage metrics are displayed on the graph. The total simulation time of 6700 seconds, which is close to 2 hours, is much better compared to the 4 hours that you'd expect if you ran these simulations in serial. You can achieve further speed up by running parallel simulations on remote clusters, giving you the benefit of connecting to typically hundreds of workers compared to a local parallel pool. You can set up the remote cluster by going to the parallel dropdown from the home tab. Then use the discover cluster option to locate clusters you could use in your network. I have already chosen a cluster here called MathWorks Public. You can also modify preferences for the parallel pool by navigating to the parallel pool preferences. Here I have chosen to use 50 workers in the remote cluster. Now that we have set this up, let's now run the simulations using this remote cluster. We see that the simulations just took around 675 seconds, which is a little over 11 minutes, thus speeding up the parameter sweep process manifold compared to the local parallel pool. Now, you might wonder if these parallel simulations work with fast restart to produce further speedup. The answer is yes. To utilize fast restart, you simply need to configure the use fast restart argument of the parsim command as on. With that set, let's run the simulations now. We see that the simulations now ran in around 621 seconds. Okay, now what if your simulation is running in rapid accelerator mode for which fast restart is not supported? For this, you can turn off the rapid accelerator up to date check to gain speed up. What you need to do is to use this set model parameter method of the simulation input object to set rapid accelerator up to date check to off. While running in rapid accelerator mode, one more needed step is to create a setup function, which will help us build the rapid accelerator target on the MATLAB workers. This step is required because the host MATLAB and the parallel workers may have different architectures. For example, a Windows host with Linux parallel workers, or for cases where the rapid accelerator target does not exist. Without the setup function, if a rapid accelerator target does not exist for the architecture corresponding to the parallel workers, the simulations will error out. This target is built only once and used by all subsequent simulations, and thus saving time for model compilation. We can then run parsim by giving in the simulation input object and the setup function as arguments. The simulation now ran in around 547 seconds. So comparing this run with the serially run parameter sweep that would take 4 hours, we see a speed up of 2600%. So now these are the ways you can go about running parallel simulations. As a recap, we saw how you can run them from your local machine or a remote cluster and using fast restart or using rapid accelerator. To close the loop, the advantage of running parallel simulations is that it saves you time, sometimes even hours, while running long iterative simulations, like parameter sweeping or Monte Carlo simulations for your models. But also keep in mind some of the trade-offs of using parallel simulation. One, there is an overhead of setting up a parallel pool of workers. Two, there is an overhead of starting simulation on those workers. And it needs a bit of scripting in MATLAB to get started, as we saw here. Lastly, you cannot run simulations that depend on each other. Thanks for watching. Please watch the next video if you're interested in learning about how to speed up simulations through model references or Simulink cache.